in close. Because the more you think you see, the easier it'll be to fool you.
Well, yeah, if you're gonna use jump cuts. Yeah, hell, I can do that. This dude runs over here, grabs a pipe or something, and then hits the glass twice before the timer even moves 5 seconds. Jeez, this is the most disgusting magic trick ever. It's like magic meets Saw. In all this commotion and with no visual cues, how could Henley make herself heard to reveal that she wasn't eaten by piranha? Seriously? You've got a half-naked chick on top of you asking you to do 52 tricks to her, and you somehow get distracted by a piece of tarot card that's hanging out of a discarded shoe several feet away? She's standing even with him right here, but then has to take a step forward to be even with him in the next shot.
Oh no, nothing's ever locked.
Of course. This is the world of movies, where you don't need to be a magician to unlock things as long as you have something straight and metal.
The Four Horsemen!
Thank you!
For our final trick!
Final trick? They just f***ing introduced you!
1, 2, 3!
Wow, the big shot Vegas magicians can jump and high five, but only after counting it down out loud.
I'm sorry, sir,
Has Morgan Freeman been typecast as the guy who brings cell phones where cell phones are not allowed? The real magic trick this movie pulls is making you feel like you're watching a Nolan film when you're actually watching a movie from the guy who brought you Transporter 2 and Clash of the Titans. I know this is a magic show, but what? Did these people pay a lot of money to see a 7-minute magic show? A magician who cops believe just stole 3.2 million euros is given a deck of cards to play with during the interrogation. This. Also, you have to go really slow to see it, but the cuffs go from open back to closed in between shots here.
First rule of magic, always be the smartest guy in the room.
Apparently, magicians can perform tricks even when they have no control over the environment. Wait, why did the magicians leave all their in the theater for the cops and the debunker to play with? And if they did it on purpose as part of their overall scheme, then why aren't any of these people smart enough to ask the same question I just did?
They programmed his mind to make him go to Las Vegas.
Is this for real? They just performed Inception on this guy while passing him on the street and he went to Vegas based on random suggestions?
I got his measurements.
Oh, no, you did not. I'm still pretty sure this movie isn't suggesting magic is real, but are they suggesting hypnosis is? Or that real hypnosis works in any way like this?
There is a legend of a secret order.
Let's face it. Magic Unmasked with Thaddeus Bradley is a huge success only because Morgan Freeman is the narrator.
You're in this to ride them up, I'm in it to ride them down.
Earlier he said he switched from magic to exposing magicians because the money was far better, but then he turns down an obviously wise business proposition. Now his reason appears to be some sort of vendetta against magicians. I'm kinda disappointed Alfred and Lucius had such a bad falling out after Bruce faked his death.
Here's your new number.
$70,562.
Well, sure, if you instantly believe random pieces of paper at a magic show. Also, am I the only person who would be whipping out my bank app and checking the real balance instead of shining a flashlight into an envelope?
I've got $82,000 on my bank account. It says it right here on my cell phone.
Finally, that's what I'm talking about. It takes approximately 4 seconds for everyone in the audience to pull out their phone, turn it on, open the bank app, and find the current balance. That's some magic right there. So they found a bunch of Katrina victims screwed over by Tressler and gave them a ticket to a magic show and just assumed everyone would show up? And they did? Nobody in this magic show thinks they're being duped or part of some great trick or will have any trouble keeping this money.
No, your mother's maiden name or the name of your first pet.
Okay, I'm officially calling Black Label bull on this movie. What is that? Well, it's when a movie's entire story is anchored to random acts of chance. They not only get Tressler to volunteer this information on the private jet, but then this wealthy businessman still uses stupid personal questions to unlock his sizable bank account? No one who makes hundreds of millions of dollars would leave such a glaring loophole open for any asshole to log into his account. Not to mention the stupidity of leaving $140 million in a single bank account instead of investing it or diversifying it, like any real rich person would do.
We got confirmation. It's really happening. They robbed him!
How the f*** do you confirm that in 20 seconds? Did you call his people? Did they give you his bank balance over the phone without contacting him first? Did you somehow ask him while he was on stage? F*** your movie cop omniscience. Lady, you just got 70 grand of his money. What the hell are you still angry about?
Please!
Aw, give me a f***ing break already with the hypnosis sh*t, please. Since we later find out that Dylan is actually orchestrating all of this, why would he even bother to yell freeze knowing he's gonna be tackled by 20 people? There seem to be a lot of beads in this crowd, but not nearly enough breasts to satisfy the demand.
Mr. Tressler would like you to join him for a drink.
How can Tressler afford to pay these bodyguards now that he's broke?
You, sir, are the abracadabra.
Or it might be called the turn. Am I right?
Whatever you stand to make, I'll double it.
Again, how? Character pulls covers up over another character so we know they care about him, cliche.
Stop. Zoom in tighter. Tighter.
Zoom in tighter, cliche. Did anyone ever watch this tape after all this nonsense happened in here? Not even for fun?
As of this instant, we are ahead of them.
Again, why would Dylan bother with this tactic? and to go through all this trouble just to try and catch magicians he's hired, other than to throw everyone watching the movie off the scent. The amount of convenience in this scene is overwhelming. They predicted every single move this cop would make in a fight. If they can do that, why do they need to do these magic shows and shit? I mean, they're basically gods. What if the French chick doesn't steal the BMW from the civilian? Then they could never chase them in the first place. How is that part of the plan? Did the magicians assume that the cop would somehow find a car and be able to keep pace?
Why the hell did you take this case?
Considering Dylan is behind all of this, there seems to be no motive at all to being a dick to Alma, other than the movie's desperate orgy of evidence that Dylan is not the droid we're looking for.
You tell me what's going on, because this is bullshit!
Movie says what everyone in the audience is thinking.
What's going on here, Rhodes?
I don't know!
Well, that was a worthy use of screen time.
As our, let's call it, year of living dangerously.
All of this was coordinated in a year? Robbing the armed truck and putting on three magic shows, one requiring the power to persuade a Frenchman to fly to Vegas, another requiring locating hundreds of Katrina victims screwed over by Tressler, and this elaborate final act, the not really a magic show, but something people would riot over because it's so disappointing finale? And all that other shit in between, like convincing Tressler to back them financially in the first place?
Thank you for the magic, and thank you for being such an incredible and dedicated audience.
For 3 days.
But it's time for us to disappear.
So this entire final show consists of you guys appearing in a video and then showing up in a couple different places on the roof? Kind of a finale, if you ask me. What the kind of movie am I watching here? The magicians pin the safe robbery on the black guy. These people could not walk openly on the streets of New York City without being mobbed. Do these assholes know they're in one of the biggest public places ever? I'm pretty sure several of the screens in Times Square are devoted to ads. Or at least dedicated premeditated video reels. They're not all playing the f***ing news.
Form the whole room into a giant rabbit box.
Because this is easy to do with 3 people and almost no time to pull it off. Did the FBI really leave Common in here playing his imaginary violin?
Unless, of course, he didn't.
Is Morgan Freeman's entire job in this movie to explain f*** to the audience? So they coordinated this dangerous wreck that could have killed anyone on the bridge if the slightest thing went wrong? And this asshole Dylan is poking around in a car he knows has a cadaver in it? And that he knows is about to blow up?
The insurer who denied the family's claim, Tressler Insurance.
You mean Tressler Insurance didn't want to pay money to the family of the magician who couldn't perform a dangerous trick that led to his death? What an asshole. These cards move by themselves. Wait, magic is real?
Welcome to the eye.
But if they only got away with it because you gave them the plan in the beginning and you were running the investigation the whole time, then why the f*** do they deserve to get into the eye? I mean, it was all you, right? They just followed directions. Somewhat well-known actor gets a cameo in a newspaper photo.
Safe manufacturer. And when he got to the bottom of the river, the safe warped and he was trapped.
Are we really supposed to sympathize with Dylan here? The safe manufacturer didn't do anything wrong. Hell, if anything, Shrike's death is a fine testimonial to the unbreakable quality of the safes.
Yeah, but the one thing that I couldn't imagine happening was you.
Seriously? Some French chick? You planned for every single f***ing thing in this movie except a pretty girl?
The Four Horsemen.
Thank you.
You don't think I deserve your attention?
You have part of my attention. You have the minimum amount.
But I'm telling you, these walls are funny. First you hate them, and you get used to them. Enough time passes, you get so you depend on them.
One more secret to lock away.
That's my secret, Captain. I'm always angry.